write down addition of nitrosyl chloride. Addition of nitrosyl chloride, NOCl. Right. It gives NO plus and Cl minus. So the reaction of alkene with NOCl gives CCl. NITRPROSYL, nitrosyl chloride.
So which one's weaker, NaIO4 or KIO4?
Weaker in the sense what?
Like weaker of the oxidizer.
See, NaIO4 and KIO4. Both will give Na plus N, IO4 minus, K plus N, IO4 minus. Right. So Na plus, K plus, which one has a bigger size? K. So K will stabilize this more than this. That's why this one is better. Okay. It is a reaction with nitrosyl chloride. The product you write down. The product forms here is halo nitroso derivative. It is nitroso chloride compound. Halo means chloro nitroso compound. It is basically the general compound is chloro nitroso compound. One important thing here is what? Why I have discussed this is there in alkyl halide and aldehyde ketone chapter. If there is any hydrogen present here. Right, then the reaction, then this is not the major product here, okay? But this converts into what? CCl, C double bond N OH. CCl, C double bond N OH. What is the name of this compound? This is oxime. C double bond NOH is oxime. Can you tell me how this product forms? This one.
Second
carbon, 3 bond. 1, 2, 3, 4. This one. Yeah. This I have, it can be anything, hydrogen or any alkyl. It's just a C double bond C reaction. One example I have taken, if it is hydrogen, then what happens? It can be anything, hydrogen, alkyl group.
What?
Yeah, whatever is here, that will be here. Yeah, if it is R, H, and R, then here also it is R, H, and R. But if it is hydrogen here, not alkyl group, then this further converts into this. Why this conversion is there and how this conversion is possible? Can you tell me? Totemization padha hai? What is that? It is nitroso-oxime totemerism. Right, no. Try it. H comes over here and this bond, double bond comes over here. C double bond, N over here. What happened? Oxime formations. Very important. This oxime is, we'll see the reaction in another chapter. But oxime formation is very important. Okay?
So is there some difference for which side?
No. It's just a sin addition. Both sides. It's very simple.
So if I, if on one carbon I have RR, on the one I have HR.
Yes.
Then will it
in that case, yeah, we'll get a positive charge in the carbon which is RR.
Because
more stable positive charge. Yeah.
So because which one of these is positive?
Which one of in this case, so anything is possible. Both are same. So if you write here, both give the same answer.
No, sir. Which out of Cl and NO, which one is the
NO plus and Cl minus. It is nitrosonium ion, NO plus. And this is chloride ion, Cl minus. Okay, next write down.
So, is there a third type of product that is inside this and
Diatride in space.
No.
It is triad.
Triad.
Keto enol is very common one, but it is triad only. Possible with nitroso and oxy. Like keto enol, we have so nitroso, oxy, triad form. Triad. Okay, next slide down.
So what do you mean triad?
I have discussed it, right? Yeah, totem is a nick, yeah.
No, no, so you did it. I forgot what triad.
Triad is this. So it is 1, 2, and 3. So hydrogen from the third atom. It goes on to the first atom. And double bond from between first and second atom
goes
it shifts between the second atom. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, that's right.
Okay. So even this thing is a triad.
This one is triad. This one 1, 2, and 3. 1, O, and S. Okay, write down next. Diels Elder reaction. We'll finish this alkene. Two, three more reactions, that is it. So it is 2,4 addition reaction. I'll just give you the example, there is no theory. 2,4 means one molecule has carbon, two carbon atoms, CH2 double bond CH2. And when this is allowed to react with CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH, double bond CH2. Okay? So 2,4 addition it is. 2,4 addition. 4 carbon, 2 carbon. Here you see what happens. It is a conjugated system, right? Conjugated system. So this converts into what? If you write down the resonating structure, you get CH2, CH double bond CH, single bond CH2, negative and positive. Okay. Now this negative charge, if I write down this molecule here, CH2 double bond CH2. So when these two molecules come closer for the reaction, so this charge separation polarizes this pi bond also, the weak pi bond. So what you can write, this negative charge attack onto this carbon atom, this comes over here, and this attacks onto this carbon atom. Right, and what you will get? You will get a cyclic structure here. And if you see the structure is this, isn't it?
This is like a thing between two molecules.
Yes.
So will all of the first product, when there are two double bonds, will all of it convert into the next station and become the cyclic compound?
Only one molecule.
Yeah, but like...
Yeah, it will convert into the Tell me the product of this reaction. Okay, so what happens here? This comes over here and this comes over here, right? This bond will break pi bond, so 4 plus 2 will have a 6 member ring. This side we have double bond COOH and COOH. It is dicarboxylic acid, correct? Now one more thing important here. This, when you heat this compound, right, we haven't done this, but we'll discuss it. Right? When you heat this compound, then this eliminates water molecule and forms anhydride. Okay, cyclic anhydride. So the structure is the structure we get.
How do you use H2?
One thing you remember, we'll discuss this reaction in one chapter called heating effect of compounds. Okay, compounds, when you heat this, then what is the product possible? Okay, there is nothing a chapter like this, heating effect. Okay, but we'll discuss that. Heating effect separately, we'll see that. But what happens, suppose if you have a compound like COOH, CH2, and COOH. When you heat this compound, then what is the product you get? Okay, so if N value is 0 or 1, okay, N value is 0 or 1, then on heating this, you'll get what molecule eliminates? CO2 molecules goes out into this. Okay. For example, if I suppose karo, this is the reaction, oxalic acid. Okay? Oxalic acid, if you heat, N value is 0 here, right? So if you heat, then CO2 molecules goes out and the product is HCOOH. Means one of the CO2 you remove from this. HCOOH. So there is no other way. Okay, carboxylic acid ka heating effect is this. So if you have COOH, CH2OH also, then also the product will be what? CH3COOH. Can you tell me? This product is what? COOH, CH2COOH. On heating this, this CO2 goes out. H comes over here. CH3COOH. Okay, JEE Mains, they have asked many questions, a lot of questions on this particular thing. You'll get some carboxylic acid in between somewhere, and then the last, they'll heat this. Okay? So, CO2 goes out when N is 0 or 1. Okay, you won't get all these things in any book. Okay, that's why I always say write on notes. We'll talk about it later. Now, we'll just copy this. I said no. Heating effects will do separately, right? Now, when N is 2 and 3, number of this molecule is 2 or 3, then H2O molecules goes out. Okay? It gets only H2O molecules goes out. If N is 4 and 5, itna hi yaad rakhna zyada hai. Both CO2 and H2O go. Theek hai, fir aage likho. Wo karna nahi hai, kahan tak jao, 10 tak chale jaoge. Itna hi agar lo kaafi hai. More than that. Theek hai, so in this one you see, between these two COOH, you have two carbon atom present. Right, two carbon atom present, then what happens?
H2O.
N value is what? N value is 2, right? So H2O goes out. So this H and this.
So it's CH2, right?
Here is just CH. No, 2-alkyl group. Means we have 2-alkyl group in between them. See, this structure is C double bond OOH. And this is C double bond OOH. Mechanism is how that when you heat this, you see here. See, any one of this lone pair. This attacks onto this carbon atom because it is polarized. Carbon, oxygen, electronegativity. It's partial positive charge. So, kya banega? Carbon O minus OH. C double bond O, O, H plus. Now, this H plus comes out to stabilize this oxygen atom, and this H plus is taken up by this oxygen. Okay? Means this H plus makes this group as a good leaving group. So, kya ban gaya? Double bond C O minus oxygen. C double bond O, and here we get O H2 plus. Now what happens? This lone pair of electron comes over here, and this bond pair. Okay, and we get anhydride C double bond O. Only one water molecule. However, you won't get this reaction in this chapter. Okay, it's there in the carboxylic acid. Next, write down. Write down.
Ozone analysis.
3 with Zn. This is the product we get. This molecule intermediate one is ozonide. Formation of ozonide first, and then it is heated with zinc dust. ZnO goes out, and you will get this product. The product of this reaction can be an aldehyde, or ketone, or both aldehyde or ketone, depending upon the structure of alkene. All three products possible.
I mean, in this case.
Bond will dissociate. Write on the product in this reaction. The ring will dissociate, the bond, the double bond will dissociate.
Yeah.
Means if you have like this. If you have like this. Okay. So when you do the ozone analysis of this, you get many compounds into this one. Yahan pe bhi hoga, yahan pe bhi hoga, yahan pe.
You get three compounds.
All three bonds. Ring break, that's
what CHO, CHO, right?
Product, if you write down, product will be this. Dekho, yahan pe hai. It will be C, H, CH, double bond O, three molecules of this. What? We'll get HCHO and CH3. Analysis, these two product forms. Okay, you need to write down the structure of the alkene which gives this product, and how many such structures possible.
Not how many.
How many? Only one is possible.
But the one such I got, right?
That one is right. Other one?
So they got a scorpion.
He said the other one. He said the
third one.
How to draw this structure now?
So is the other one just a double device?
What are you doing?
I think this is correct.
So because I'm bad at this,
See, actually what happens, the product of this is what? You just have to break this bond and write down the double bond O with these two carbon. Okay, you see, how do we write down the product? For this one, you see, we have this CH3 double bond, O2C double bond, CH2, right? The ozonolysis product of this is what? We just have to remove this double bond, add double bond O here and double bond O here. This is what we are getting there. Right, so if this is given, you have to write down the original structure of alkene. What we'll do, we'll remove this oxygen atom. You just have to remove this O and O and attach this carbon with a double bond. Right, so if you see, this is the two molecule, right? This two, right? So, the alkene, the structure of alkene is what? This is the structure of alkene, right?
Yes.
Which on ozonolysis gives this two product, okay? Now, this is the structure of alkene, and across this double bond, GI is possible, right? So, we can have cis and trans, two such structure possible. Right, two such structure possible.
This is the most stable one, right?
E is obviously the most stable one. So that I do
one more. Yes, E.
What else?
Preparation. Write down. First one. By dehydrohalogenation.
Yes, sir.
You didn't ask why I was sent.